So everyone take out your moments. Today we will be starting the last chapter from this book. That is The Beggar. Page number 62. So let us begin. So The Beggar is a story written by Anton Chekhov. So Anton Chekhov is a very famous short story writer. Okay. So he is a Russian. So he is a famous short story writer. You will have lots and lots of short stories on his name. If you want to buy any of his stories, you can get a collection of it. Okay, so he is kind of famous regarding this part. So let us come to the story, The Beggar. So this story is about a beggar whose name was Lashkov. Okay, Lashkov is the name of the beggar. So what exactly happened to that beggar? How from being a beggar he got changed and he became a normal gentleman? Okay, so the story of transformation, how it happened, how it took place. So this is what the story is all about. Kind sir, have pity, turn your attention to a poor, hungry man. For 3 days I had nothing to eat. I haven't 5 kopecks for a lodging. I swear it before God. For 8 years I was a village school teacher, and then I lost my place through intrigues. I fell a victim to calumny. It's a year now since I have had anything to do. So this is the dialogue of a beggar. He is begging. He is asking someone to give him some money because he is hungry. He hasn't eaten anything for days. Okay, and he is not even having a small money of 5 kopecks. Now, kopecks is a currency of that area. So he is not even having enough money to get himself a lodging, get himself a shelter. Means he is without any kind of shelter. He is just on the street. Okay, and he is promising on God's name that I swear it on God. For 8 years I was a village school teacher. I'm telling the truth. My condition was not like this. I was having a profession of a teacher. I used to teach in a village school. And he is telling that I swear I'm telling the truth. And there somehow he was not able to hold on the job because some kind of corruption kind of thing happened, internal corruption happened. Okay, different kinds of falsehood, politics, everything happened, and he lost his job. Okay, so intrigues means different types of internal politics, and I fell victim to a calumny. Calumny means a falsehood. Someone said something, some kind of lie and some kind of thing, and he suffered and he lost his job. And he lost his job, and it's been a year now, and he has nothing else to do. Okay? The advocate, now whom he was talking to? He was talking to an advocate. The advocate, Sergei, looked at the ragged, fawn-colored overcoat of the suppliant and his dull, drunken eyes at the red spot on either cheek, and it seemed to him as if he had seen this man somewhere before. So this advocate to whom the beggar was telling all these things, he was looking very closely, he was like having a very close look on this beggar, and he is trying to understand that I have seen this man somewhere. This face, this kind of red spot on the cheeks, this kind of dress, he is able to understand that somewhere I have seen, but he is not able to recognize where. Okay, but he looked very familiar to him. I have now had an offer of a position in the province of Kaluga. The mendicant went on, "But I haven't the money to get there. Help me kindly. I'm ashamed to ask, but I am obliged to my circumstances." So now the beggar is telling that, "Sir, please help me with some money. Recently, somewhere in Kaluga, they have offered me a job, and I don't have the money to travel to that place. So please kindly give me that money. If I get that money, I will be able to join that job. I will be able to get that job. Please help me. Please help me." He kept on telling the same thing. He kept on begging. Sargi's eyes fell on the man's overshoes, one of which was high and the other low, and he suddenly remembered something. So this advocate, this Sargi, he was trying to remember who this man was. He looked so familiar. Then when he looked at his shoes, suddenly he remembered, "Oh, I got it. I know who it is. Okay, I have seen him before." So what made him remember? The shoes. So one shoe was having low heel, whereas the other shoe was having high heel. Okay, means two different types of shoes he was wearing. So that clicked his mind that, yes, I know, this was that man. Okay. "Look here, it seems to me I met you the day before yesterday in Sadovia Street," he said, "but you told me that you were a student who had been expelled and not a village school teacher. Do you remember?" So now the Sargi is charging back at him. The Sargi is telling that, "I know you, I have met you, I have seen you day before yesterday in that street, Sadova Street, and at that time you said that you were a student who got expelled from your institution, you got expelled, you were a student. How you happen to become a teacher now?" Means now the Sargi is accusing him that, "You have been lying to me, you are not at all a teacher, you are not at all offered a job, you are just making up stories to get some money. So at some time you are telling you were a student, now you are telling you are a teacher. How this difference happened in these 2 days?" "No, that can't be," mumbled the beggar. Now the beggar is little bit shocked, taken aback. Okay, he is like kind of surprised, means he got into a situation, because he completely forgot that this was the man from whom day before yesterday he took the money, and again the same person he is trying to again lie with some new stories. Okay, so he got kind of shock. Okay, and he is like kind of mumbling, no, I did not say like that, it can't be so. "I am a village school teacher," he's telling, "I am a village school teacher, and if you like, I can show you my papers. If you don't believe me, I have my papers also with me. I will show you my papers." "Have you done with lying? You called yourself a student and even told me what you had been expelled for. Don't you remember?" Now this advocate is becoming like an advocate and charging on him and telling that, "You just stop lying. Don't lie anymore. You're done. Okay, you're done with your lying. Okay, because you call yourself a student and you also told me that what was the reason that you got expelled from your institution. Do I need to tell you or do you remember?" Means I remember very clearly that you were that person. I am not mistaking here, he's trying to say. Sargi flushed and turned from the ragged creatures with an expression of disgust. So this advocate was very much disappointed, very much angry, and he just kind of showed a kind of anger face and turned aside, means totally disgusted. What a liar, what a dishonest person. This is dishonesty, my dear sir, he cried angrily. "This is swindling. I shall send the police for you. Damn you." So now the Sargi is getting very angry, because the Sargi is feeling that day before yesterday he lied to me, he cheated me, and he took money from me, and that made him feel more anger. So now he's telling that, "You are such a disgusting person, you are such a dishonest person. This is swindling." Swindling means falsehood. Okay, means when people take money against some kind of lie, I mean like kind of means cheating on people, when money is taken, that is called swindling. "So this is swindling and you should be arrested. I shall call the police for that." Okay, he started charging on him again. Yes, kind of deception. "Sir," he said, laying his hand on his heart, The fact is that I was lying. I am neither a student nor a school teacher. All that was fiction. Formerly, I sang in a Russian choir and was sent away for drunkenness. But what else can I do? I can't get along without lying. No one will be giving me anything when I tell the truth. What can I do? So now he's coming on track. He's telling the truth. Yes, he's an advocate of a court. That is why he is like inquiring in such a manner. So now finally the beggar is telling the truth. The sir, he's keeping his hand on his heart and telling that the fact is, fine, I was lying. I agree that I was lying. I'm neither a school teacher, I was not a student, but my profession was that I was in a band, in a Russian choir, means he used to sing. And because he had this bad habit of drinking, that is why he got thrown away from that team. Okay, he was means fired from that team. But what else can I do? So he's telling that right now I need to lie. I need to lie and make up stories like this, then only I will get some money. Because if I tell anyone the truth, who am I? Nobody will care me to give money. So what can I do? That is why I'm doing like this. I have my own reasons for it. No, not like that. He just telling him so that whatever the situation, it's coming out. So he is telling the truth now. So now the truth is getting revealed. Work. No. What can you do? You ask, what can you do? Cried the Sargi, coming close to him. Work, that's what you can do. You must work. Means you are asking me what you should do to get money. You are asking me what you can do. You need to work. You work and earn your money. Why you need to beg? Why you need to beg in the first place? Why you need to beg? You just work. In return of your work, you will get money. Such a silly question. Work. Yes, I know that myself. But where can I find work? Work. I know what is work. I know I had this idea of working. But the problem is here, what kind of work and where I will get work? Where I will find any work? How would you like to chop wood for me? So if you are not finding any work, then I'm giving you work. You then come chop wood for me. Then the beggar is telling, I wouldn't refuse to do that. But in these days, even skilled woodcutters find themselves sitting without bread. Okay, wood cutting is fine. I won't refuse that. I won't refuse the wood cutting thing, but like I see here nowadays, woodcutters means very skilled professional woodcutters, they also don't have money to get to buy bread. And what will happen of me? I'm not even skilled in wood cutting. Okay. That one Sargi told lie or the beggar really told him. Okay. The beggar actually told him that means it may happen. Na? It is not clear in the story whether the Sargi lied or not. Okay. So according to the Sargi, he met the beggar previously in that place. And now, obviously, if the beggar has been refusing, then Sargi was telling a lie. So here, the beggar happened to meet this advocate, Sargi, the day before yesterday, and there he made a different story, and today he is making a different story. So that is why he is able to remember. That is why he was very much familiar to him. He was trying to remember, and finally those shoes made him remember. So here the Sargi is not lying. The beggar is the only person who is lying, and Sargi hated this lying activity. So he got angry. Okay? Okay. So now the advocate is telling, will you come and chop wood for me? My question is, I am giving you the job. I will pay for you. Will you just come to my home and cut wood for me? Yes, sir, I will. Okay, fine, sir, I will do that. Very well. We'll soon find out. Fine. So that is decided. You come, we'll find out what can be done of you. Sergei hastened along, rubbing his hand. He called his cook out of the kitchen. So now in the next part, Sergei is coming inside the home in a kind of hurried manner, and he's rubbing his hand because outside it is very cold. So, and he's calling out his cook. "Here, Olga," he said, "take this gentleman into the woodshed and let him chop wood." So the cook's name was Olga. So he's calling out Olga, that Olga, you take this man and take him to the woodshed, and he will be cutting woods for the home. It's not Alga, it's Olga. Yes, Olga. Okay. The scarecrow of a beggar shrugged his shoulders as if in perplexity and went irresolutely after the cook. It was obvious for his gait that he had not consented to go and chop wood because he was hungry and wanted work, but simply from pride and shame and because he has been trapped by his own words. It was obvious too that his strength had been undermined by vodka, and that he was unhealthy and did not feel the slightest inclination for toil. So now this beggar, his structure was like that of a scarecrow. Means he was very thin, malnourished. Okay, he looked exactly like a scarecrow. You can imagine what a scarecrow looks like. A thin body and like kind of, you know, oversized dress. Okay, so this beggar was also like that. Okay, completely weak and feeble body. And then like regarding this wood cutting work, now he was actually not very much interested in this work. Okay, he was not interested in this wood cutting work. He was not at all willing to do that work. Then why he came? He came because it's about all about prestige. He talked in such a big manner that, oh, I don't have any work, who will give me work? And the Sergei only given him the work. So what happened? Whatever he was talking, he got trapped in his big talk. So now he is not having any other excuses to show or to come out of it. So that is why he was bound to do what the Sergei wanted him to do. Okay. And with his means physical strength, it was really like nobody can expect him that he is fit to do any kind of laborious work. So it's not at all possible for him. Sergei is the man, the advocate, the person who took Lashkov. Yes, it's not Sergei, it's Sergei. Sergei hurried into the dining room. From its window, one could see the woodshed and everything that went on in the yard. Standing at the window, Sergei saw the cook and the beggar come out into the yard by the back door and make their way across the dirty snow to the shed. Olga glared wrathfully at her companion, shoved him aside with her elbow, unlocked the shed and angrily banged the door. So now Sergei was watching this beggar and the cook, what they are doing through the window of his home. And he was watching that the cook was having kind of temper problem. She was kind of angry. Okay, she was kind of irritated. So she was like taking the beggar near the shed, opening the door of the shed in such a like huge banging sound. Okay, pushing him inside and telling him like, go bring this, that. So the Sergei understood, okay, like she is handling the thing, she will handle, and that man is going to work. Okay, so that's it. So today we will end the class here, you know, 2 pages, and tomorrow, I don't think tomorrow we have class, so Monday, next class will be on Monday. Monday and Tuesday, I think it will take to finish the chapter. Okay, so mark it till here.